Hey everyone. Just so you know, we've been working on the guild training a little bit. It's one of the sort of major parts of the game that is sort of glaringly missing at the moment, especially now that the stats have been implemented and the gameplay will actually be reflected by what stats you have, magic being affected by wisdom and your attack damage being affected by strength and whatnot. So this is quite a big part of the game, and this is the Fighters Guild, and I'll show you what it looks like, or is looking like it. Everything you see here is probably just temporary until I confirm it 100%. But so this is your interface, and currently I'm training in strength. So these are my character's stats at the moment, and this is my proposed stats, and I can actually buff my strength by clicking the plus. And every time I do, notice that it affects my other stats, just like it would in the real game. If I was attacking a monster with a melee weapon, my intelligence and wisdom would go down. And it costs a certain amount of money to actually train, and the more I train, the higher the cost goes. Now, these costs aren't final. The test team will tell me if they're too expensive or not, once they've had a chance to play with it. But as you can see, if you've got enough gold, you can get quite extreme with it. And once your intelligence and wisdom reach zero, other stats start being affected, like your charisma and your dexterity. And eventually, your constitution starts going down. And then you run out. So, yeah. You'll notice that it doesn't add up to 100%. That's because a lot of the percentages have like a point something something, or rounded up numbers, so you start getting things that are a little bit weird. The reset button sets it back to what it was. Doesn't reset the gold yet, but it's still a work in progress at the moment. But yeah, that should show you how it works. Now, if you go to a mage's guild, you'll train in wisdom. If you go to a thieves guild, you'll train in dexterity. Your charisma, there's currently no way to train in because that's more how you actually present yourself in the game. Your intelligence, you can't train in intelligence. It's just something that you naturally have. And your constitution, you can't train in because that's about how hard you are as a person. So those three stats will be affected by what you do. The other three stats will be affected not only by what you do, but also by the guilds. So that should help people be able to really alter their characters and fine-tune them. And if you're playing a mage character and you just by coincidence have to deal with a lot of combat, a lot of times, I'm sure a lot of people that have tried playing mage characters will have just had to use their melee weapons, and they know it's affecting their stat. I've seen in Let's Plays that people get quite frustrated at that happening. So now, if that happens, you'll be able to head to the nearest town, go to a mage's guild, and tweak your wisdom back to where it was, or even give it a bit of a boost if you've got the gold for it. So, there's how that's going. So, hopefully you have enjoyed seeing that this is actually happening. What, as you can, you've seen if you've been following recent videos, this is nearly ready. The Griffin travel is well on the way to being ready, and once those two are done, I'll be able to be focusing on the new spell types and the new quest system. The new quest system has had a bit of work done on it, but nothing that I really want to show just yet. But it's not far away. Hopefully you all like that. Guilds will of course give you guild quests as well, and they'll be different to the types that you manage to get at the guild kiosk, the quest kiosks that we're putting in. So I'll be back later on with another video when I've got something more to show you. Until then, keep on rocking.